Welcome to Morning Market Call. My name is Doug Mumford, and I'm here today with Matt Schultz. Matt, thanks for being on the program.
Thanks for having me, Doug.
Matt is the Executive Vice President of Student Life within the BYU MBA program this year. Matt, tell us a little bit about what that actually means, what you do.
Well, student life encompasses all the things that the students typically do, all the fun stuff. So specifically, I work with several heads of student organizations within the MBA Association, like Athletics and Service. I also chair the committee that plans all the program-wide events like the opening social and the holiday party.
So what is your goal for your position this year? Are these events that you're talking about just an avenue for the BYU students to have fun? Or do they serve kind of a higher purpose?
Well, fun and games and food, it's all great. I love that stuff. But ultimately, my big value add and my vision for the program this year and my responsibilities is networking. Last year, networking was focused on quite a bit, and I feel that focus helped me prepare well for my internship this last summer at Coca-Cola.
So you were at Coca-Cola. Did you feel that networking was a key part of you securing the internship there?
You know, I kind of fell in my lap. I'll be honest, I don't have an amazing story about networking my way into the internship. I got it made through a pretty straightforward process of apply and interview. But the real value add for me was once I was in Atlanta. Internally, networking within Coke is really important.
Tell me a little bit more about that. So an internship's pretty short, just a few weeks. How were you able to use the skills you'd learned in networking once you were at Coke this summer?
Well, first of all, it helps a lot that they understand that you're only there for 3 months. And so you have a lot more exposure to people that you wouldn't normally have otherwise. They make time for you in their busy schedules. But two examples come to mind. The first involves another intern. She introduced me to a manager in her department. And I saw this effect of you meet one person who introduces you to another, et cetera. And this manager, we met for lunch, met again, established a good rapport, and he felt comfortable introducing me to other people, not just random people within the company, but we looked at places of interest for me personally. Where would I want to end up if I came back? And so he introduced me to several people from the analyst level all the way up to the director level. And it was great. And I learned through that experience that it's really important to establish a good connection first. Don't ask for favors until somebody knows you, because when they introduce you to someone, they're more or less putting their stamp of approval, their validation on you as a person, as an individual, as a coworker, as a professional. And so if they don't feel comfortable with you on that level, they're not going to feel comfortable with you introducing you to others. And so it's really important to establish that connection initially. The second example actually happened here on campus last winter. One of our classmates, Britt Chapman, I believe he was on the show recently.
Yeah.
And we were in the same class, some finance classes together. And he lived in Atlanta. And he has a good friend who works at Coca-Cola. He's been there for about 13 years. Well, he made the connection once I word got around that I had an internship there, and he came up to me, made the connection, introduced me via email, and I met with his friend several times. He wound up being a good friend of mine, and he introduced me to a finance manager, and then she introduced me to two other finance managers, and so on. And it was really a great experience, and it enriched my time there at the Coca-Cola company. And looking back on that, I'm not sure that if Brett didn't know me, if I had made myself available through the various activities and networking with my peers, I doubt that would ever happen. He wouldn't have even known I was going to Atlanta.
Great story about networking. For the last question, what message do you have for our current class of MBA students?
Well, it's so easy to get focused on schoolwork and to be more or less myopic, put the blinders on and do what you're going to be measured on right away. But invest in yourself, invest in your network, and it'll pay off in the short term and the long term. Additionally, you won't just learn about your peers and your classmates, develop good relationships here, but going through those motions and those actions will prepare you for interfacing with professionals this summer, your internship at information sessions and informational interviews. And it's just invaluable, and you can't miss that.
Matt, thank you so much for being on our show. We appreciate having you.
Thanks for having me.
My name is Doug Mumford. This has been Morning Market Call. Please tune in next time.
Morning Market Call is brought to you by the Marriott School of Management in cooperation with the Brigham Young University Department of Communications. MMC is made possible by generous donations from Larry Tasjan and Gary Williams. This show was produced by Jeff Butler, Janessa Cloward, David Wood, and Doug Mumford, with line producing by Beth Grimmett. For more information, please follow us on Twitter and Facebook.